It's easy to integrate 3D text directly into Adobe Premiere from Adobe After Effects. To start, edit a clip to a new sequence to serve as some background video for a text object. Next, right-click in the project window area and choose New Item, Adjustment Layer. An adjustment layer box will appear with default values that equal the size of your active sequence. Press the OK button to create the adjustment layer. Edit the adjustment layer to the sequence. Then, right-click on the adjustment layer. Choose Replace with After Effects Composition. This will open Adobe After Effects, and it will ask you to give a name to the new project being created. Give the project a name and press Save. Now, within After Effects, navigate to the upper left corner and click on the Text tool. Then navigate to the Canvas window and type some text. In doing so, this will create a text layer. The color and size of the text object is based on what's selected within the Character tab window. Navigate down to the text layer and twirl down the disclosure triangle for the layer. Then, click in the third empty box to the right of the layer to convert it to a 3D layer. In the upper right corner of the Canvas window, click on the Renderer button. This will open the Composition Settings window. Change the renderer to Ray Traced 3D. Then click on the Options button. This is where you specify the ray tracing quality. For this demonstration, I'm going to leave the quality set to 1, because increasing the quality will exponentially increase the render time. Press the OK key to exit the dialog boxes. Next, navigate to the Layer menu and choose New Light. Go ahead and choose a color for your light. This is also where you can choose the intensity, cone angle, and cone feather of the light source. Navigate back to the Layer menu and choose New Camera. This is where you can specify the type of camera lens and film size. Press OK to close the dialog box. Navigate back to the Composition tab within the timeline and twirl down the disclosure triangle for geometry options. Next, go ahead and adjust the extrusion depth of the text object. You can also add a bevel by clicking on the Bevel Style menu. In this example, I'll choose a concave bevel. Then, go ahead and specify the bevel depth. To animate the text object, navigate to the After Effects toolbar and click on the Camera tool. Move over to the Canvas area and adjust the camera position. Then, navigate back to the Timeline window and twirl down the disclosure triangle for the camera layer. Then, twirl down the disclosure triangle for the transform parameters. Click on the stopwatch for the position parameter. This will add a keyframe to the timeline. Now move the time indicator forward 1 second. Move back over to the canvas again and readjust the camera. Okay, now navigate to the File menu and choose Save. Then move back to Adobe Premiere. Your 3D title will automatically appear within the old adjustment layer. Then click on the text layer and navigate to the Sequence menu and choose Render Selection. After the clip renders, let's check it out. For other great tips like this, or to enroll in a Premiere or After Effects training class, visit geniusdv.com.